Arbitration is the preferred mode. Arbitration itself is litigation, to be honest. You see, at the end of the day, I'll just add one more thing that, you know, we talk about litigation and all the arbitration is a process to find a solution to a problem, like the litigation is a process. Maybe the formalities are different. We go to the court and here we go to the arbitrate. You measure the pros and cons and then take a decision. Hope I'm clear.
Thank you, sir.
Thanks, ma'am.
Good afternoon, sir.
My question is, sir,
that won't there be disparity when there's an appeal, then less difficult to get a stay of award? Then what will the recourse over there?
No, now once there is no stay of the award.
So it's difficult to get a stay on an award.
Difficult to
get a stay on an award.
It's difficult now. What happened? You know, previously what was it was, you know, you just file the appeal. The statute allows it. Now what will happen, there is a procedures in court. I'll just, once your question goes to that point, I'll just give you a brief shot. There is a procedure in court which is called ex parte or non-ex parte. Ex parte is basically you do a step without informing the other party, you approach the court and you try to do something. And non-ex parte is basically before going to the court, you have to give a notice to the other party that I'm going to the court. It's like a caveat. Now what happens that under 34 old, you just file the appeal. You don't need to inform. The appeal is filed and numbered and then the process of the court will inform the other side. So once I do a unilateral act on my behalf, my order, award which is against me is stayed. It's there. I don't need to worry for another 10 years. But now what happens, I file the appeal but I have to file an application. That application you have to give a notice to the other side. So he is on caveat by law. He has to come before the court, and so then once the argument is there, the court will decide whether it is worth staying or not. So I think this is a good amendment to the statute, and it was required, to be honest. Yeah. Thank you, ma'am.
Good afternoon, sir.
Afternoon, ma'am.
Hello. Sir, my name is Nidhi. So my question is this. So is the whole process of arbitration is confidential, or if I tell something to my arbitrator, will it be with him only or will it be open to general public?
It will be with him, because when the arbitrator is sitting, he's adjudicating a dispute. He's not the court, but he's a person appointed as an arbitrator having a statutory powers. He has to keep everything confidential. So I think you don't need to worry on that, whether he'll divulge the information of the proceedings to a third party. Then issue of his partiality, impartiality, dependence, all those things which are highlighted in the section 12 will come into picture. You know, and he is giving a declaration that he is independent. So no arbitrator will do it ethically.
And sir, in all matters we are allowed to go in the appeal in the matter of
The section 30, all the orders passed, all matters means, sorry ma'am, I didn't get you.
But it's like, say, in the criminal matters, we cannot go in arbitration or...
No, in criminal, no. It has to be a civil.
Yes, exactly. And yeah. So in all civil matters, we cannot go in appeal.
I think you're trying to say that if an order is passed by an arbitrator, what is my recourse? In some cases, you can file an appeal, and in some cases, no, you can't. Okay. Because in India, we have a good hierarchy of appeal stage, which... again leads to time and everything. You know, nowhere in the written constitution 3 to 4 stages of appeals are allowed. We are a very liberal society where such a beautiful right has been given, but unfortunately for one reason or another it's been abused.
Thank you, sir.
Thanks, ma'am.
Okay, thank you so much. On behalf of MCO Legals, we would like to thank the faculty and our learners. It's been a wonderful experience, and yes, we would hope to be associated with this esteemed institute in future also, in form of moot competitions or whatever cultural events you have. We would love to know the details about those. Okay, thank you so much. Thank you.
We would like to thank Mr. Amit and Ms. Munmun for enlightening the bright minds of the learners and sharing with them their thoughts and experiences.
So let me just take this opportunity to thank the ones who made it to the lecture by themselves. And I would request others to thank me for making it to them to attend it. But yes, two good developments which are taking place in the field of law. One is, as sir just spoke about it, about the new legislations, the problems in the previous legislation so taken care. But there is a creature called lawyer who always will figure out a way out and will create new issue. But as far as I have been seeing, he just referred to a term that, like in Maharashtra, now with respect to arbitration, now I think they also appointed the registrar and made her other name.
Okay.
Yes, they appointed. And second is opening of the field to the foreign firms. Please keep reading on it. These lectures, which are organized, they are of immense importance to you if you really want to be part of that competition which is coming. Attending law school only is not sufficient. Knowing what is taking place into the industry, you must be aware. Hardly a week or month may be going when sir would not be attending any conference or any meetings which has nothing to do with business, which has nothing to do with profession, but it's greatly learning what is coming up. This is just an urge from our side that always look out for those opportunities attained. The good thing, you are in Delhi NCR. You have lots of time. I'm talking about the fourth years and fifth years. You are about to get into the profession. I presume you are professionals. So when such lectures, not only on campus, elsewhere are happening, go attain, because these are experienced ones and they are ready to share those experiences with you. You would be a bit ahead than others. Please understand this point. I could see the quality of questions when it comes from fourth year, fifth years, but I don't say that the questions asked by the second years are less important, because question comes out of zeal, and it's good that you are enthusiastic. And the questions which come from the fourth year and fifth years, it comes based on what they have read or experienced. But this experience or the question is based upon what they have studied, what they have tried to understand. So it's their own creation. So sometimes we see any lecture as compulsory, or lunch break, tha vagera. I understand that. But don't try to be emotional, because the choice is taken off you the moment you took admission into a professional program called law. Right? And law does not allow you to be emotional. It doesn't allow you to take sides. It allows you to be by its side. So you don't have side. You be by the side of law. So it's good. Well, of course, good to see, and I would definitely thank the, of course, fourth years, fifth years. I could see a few from third, greatly the second years, that you all came. And please attain all these lectures. Again, I am telling you, and I have learnt a lot after coming to Delhi NCR specifically. Whenever I get opportunity, I just go and attend those sessions. I am telling you, I was not so when I was in Pune. I owe it to the place. I owe it to the people I have met. And I come to know every day that I don't know. I have so much to learn from them. and they are so good, because as when we started the GST series, I was just talking to Sir, taxation for me, it's a alien, truly speaking. But the way Mr. Lakshmi Kumaran shared his views, and I really got to know, and you may be knowing, 4 states have ratified, right? And just look at the states, and then he made a distinction, the contributing state and the consumer states. And then I really got to know what does he mean by that, and the way he explained. So these are the things, these differences only can be shared by the ones who are practicing, one who are testing it every day. Look, on arbitration I have been attending, but today I could learn few more things, though I have been attending several of them. The 6 months period, as you say, in one conference somebody say it can be extended. But as he has rightfully said, it cannot be. You have no choice. Because that's the main core of arbitration or the alternative dispute resolution. Within span, you need to. So please focus on this. And somebody asked this, institutional and ad hoc. Good question. Almost everybody is advising institutional. Why? Even the legislation, why does it cater to that need? Experiences of the past. So please see, everything is so related, and those who really want to wear the hat that of a successful professional, having lots of salary, it comes with a gain which comes without no pain. That's called a study. So keep learning, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you very much. Thank you very much, sir.